And now for your weekly dose of metal. Here are your hosts, Morgan Danielle and Luke O'Blaze, on The Metal Experience.
And how are you? He waves. I am Luke O'Blaze with Morgan Danielle. Sitting across from me, Rabbi Dave, that guy Bill. We just heard a couple of Two Tree songs. We heard some Killswitch Engage, This Fire Burns, Korn, Trash, and Lamb of God, Terror and Hubris in the House of Frank Pollard.
I farted already.
Are you guys farting in here?
Oh, my God.
Jesus.
Jordan, was that you?
Dan, just close your legs.
Oh, we are in the studio tonight with One Steel Wound.
Woo!
Woo! What's going on, guys?
Wu-Tang.
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 Why don't you guys go ahead and reintroduce yourselves to the world and what you do and the band?
Yeah, we're One Steel Wound.
Is that Mike on?
Yeah, this is Mike.
What's going on? There we go.
No, the mic. Yeah, the mic is on. Yeah, we're One Steel Wound. We're a metal band, and yeah, I don't know. What's
Who are
up?
You?
What's going on?
He's Mike. He's already fucked up his eyeball over here.
Yeah, I know, right? I'm Brandon.
He can't see the microphone because his eyes are dangling in the way.
Would someone remind remind Mike that he has to tell who he is?
Oh, yeah. You go first. Here.
Like, what instrument do you play?
Yeah. Oh, okay. I'm Mike. I play the drums. And next right here is Brandon.
Thanks for telling me and telling everyone else. I'm Brandon. I scream.
And I have my own microphone.
Oh, shit.
You can't see with the eyeballs bouncing all over
Brandon
the place.
Yeah.
I am Gerard, and I slap the bass.
I'm Dan, and I play guitar.
Slap the bass.
And you guys have two friends sitting outside here that we couldn't fit into this.
They can room. Fit in here.
We just didn't want them in here.
That's Chris and Jeff.
And what do they do? Are they your service?
No. This is the, he supplies the weed, and
oh <my God>.
Jeff is like the part-time manager. And a great one at that.
Yeah.
So, where's the bull?
Oh, see that
in the car.
Yeah. I mean, he said he supplied it. Where is it right now?
It's kind of hidden.
Kidding. Yeah.
He likes to sell recreational drugs on the streets.
Yeah. All right. Cool.
He doesn't.
They've constructed a series of breathing apparatuses using weed and. They can get high without bowls. It's pretty interesting. It's like a whole scientific thing. I really don't want to go into it right now, but
because you look like a mad scientist.
Right? as your eyeballs are dangling around.
Yeah,
you got a kink in your eyeballs.
Broke one.
Yeah, this is what happens when you do so many drugs for so many years.
Your eyeballs fall out of your.
For the
eyes?
Listeners, he actually has some googly
those things
eyes
are gonna
on
make
right
him
now.
So dizzy, you're gonna have to carry him to the car.
I know, right? They look cool. I mean.
Well, not because the one's broken. They don't look so cool.
Well, I look like I have a disability.
Oh, my God.
So what have you guys been... Oh, my God.
Disability. I need to collect my check, dude.
All right.
I'll take the mic.
Good thinking. The mic goes to Mike. So tell us a little bit about what you guys have been up to since the last time that you were on here. This guy needs help. I'm getting distracted.
We've been recording the album and not playing any shows, but we got one lined up at Mojo's. But the album's been going pretty smooth.
It's been a lot of fun.
Pretty
eye-opening. Smooth. Awesome.
Eye-opening.
Producer Steve Eldridge, co-producing with us, and he's doing a top-class job. No fist fights yet. We're not doing a
There's
corner
been fist fights before?
No. Okay. No. We're just Close. Not pulling like Slipknot or Korn or anything. No fist fights.
Okay.
Slipknot. Cool.
Just a lot of yelling.
Yeah.
Now, the show that you have coming up on Mojo's, tell us a little bit about that, because that's one of the reasons why I wanted to get you guys on here. It's short notice, so thank you for that.
Yeah, we actually got contacted by a guy. His name was Ryan from Gorilla Music. Really nice guy. Gorilla Music is trying something new. They wanted to get the bands an opportunity to be heard. So they selected seven bands that they wanted to get the opportunity to get this chance. And we've worked with them before, and they heard us, and they wanted us to give us that opportunity, and they've seen that, you know, that we can put on a show, and they wanted us to do it again, and this time to try to get something big out of it. So, yeah, we're just looking forward to it, and, you know, just, it's, you know, it's going to be really cool, because that's the day we actually get to debut our pro lighting system.
Ooh,
so,
pro lighting system.
Yeah.
And who's running that for you?
He is not here right now, but that's Dalton the Man Kister. He is not here.
The main yeah. what?
The man. That's the man.
The man kisser?
Yeah, the Kister.
The man kisser?
Maybe.
Kister.
He's a little flamboyant, if you don't mind me.
What am I missing out on?
There.
He smokes weed, too. If you're just
oh.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he's
man
suddenly
kisser
okay
smokes
now.
Marijuana. All right.
It makes sense. He just gets super high and likes to kiss dudes. It's normal.
Hey, man, everybody. Whatever. All right.
So what time do you guys go on? And I know that you guys are selling some tickets, so how can people get a hold of you for that and come out and see you? Details, please.
Doors open at 4, right?
Yeah, 4. Yeah. Oh, actually, 3:30, but the show starts at 4.
Ooh.
So
ooh.
We're going to be standing out in front and selling them right there on the spot, too. So.
No. Well, yeah, what they're trying a new thing because one of the things that we are, as a lot of bands know, that there's a lot of pre-sales that go around, and you know it sucks because like a band shouldn't have to do a certain amount of tickets to play a show. So what Gorilla Music did is that they gave us 100 tickets, and they said, look, this is the way we're going to do it. You can bring no people, and you can still play. They're just saying that the RSVPs help you pick whatever time slot you want.
Gotcha.
That's it. So that's why it helps us out a lot more when people buy tickets now for this one especially.
So what time are you hoping to play?
Probably around, like, from what when I talked to him last time, it looks like 7:30-ish.
Okay, that's awesome. That's and you guys fun. Are selling tickets, and how can people get a hold of you, and how much are they?
They're $10 a ticket, buying them just in advance, and I think $12 at the door.
Yeah.
$15.
Huge difference if you're not buying them from these guys.
So, yeah you can contact us on the band page.
Just right on the wall.
Yeah.
We make personal deliveries.
708-497-0161.
That just happened.
And it's out there in the world forever.
For those that want to listen to the show again, just replay that anytime you want to get Dan's number.
And we always deliver.
Yeah, it's Dan's number.
Dan, how many times I got to fucking tell you, stop giving out my number over the air.
Let Dan know what you want him to wear when he delivers your package.
Picture messages.
Now, who else is playing that
Do you know your competition
show?
Well?
We do not, but they told us that the genres, there's two alternatives, two hard rock. One, like, heavy rock, and then us.
Just one heavy rock.
Like, yeah.
Like, hard rock?
Like a boulder?
No, like, rock. Yes, like a gigantic
rock. Bring it in, boys.
Rock.
And they chose one metal band. And
we play heavy rock music.
How do you even classify between rock and heavy rock? I mean,
what's the difference between heavy rock and metal?
Here we go.
I could
give your definition. More durable. We'll go along one's the line here. Let's start with everybody going this way, starting with Mike. I don't know the word that I'm looking for, but
differentiates.
Whatever Gerard said. Word. Yes, that's, I'm not good at that's English, the word so right it's better
that's
somebody
the
else
word
pronounces
right
it.
There.
What do you see as the fine line between rock and hard rock and metal
and cock rock?
We know what cock rock is, obviously.
I'd say just the intensity of the overall music, like.
Give us
vocally.
An example. Who would you consider hard rock and rock?
Would Creed be considered hard rock?
No, that's pussy music.
If so, then I don't know why you'd want to be in that genre.
Hey, fuck off. I like Creed.
Can you pull some Creed
Creed's
up?
The shit.
Can
no, let's you not listen to Creed. It's a metal experience.
Hey, do your cover to Creed, dude.
What? I don't know.
You can do Creed?
Cover.
No. Do your cover.
What if?
I do that with arms wide open.
No, what?
I can't do that shit, man.
No,
dude. Anyways, I consider the difference between metal and rock for me is really like tunings. Well, it's kind of a guitar tunings, and also too like
it's gotta go.
Looks like you want to rap right.
We're laying
down. Getting a lot of hand motions. Gripping the mic.
I feel too. It's the whole dress appearance, man. Like
leather pants. That's hard. Leather pants is hard rock, right? Leather pants could also be metal.
I mean,
oh, man.
A lot of metal musicians look like hobos. I mean, look at me, dude.
I mean, you're.
Oh, I love this. You think you look homeless?
Your eyes are falling out of your body.
I cannot take you seriously with those glasses on.
With her
arms wide open.
All right. That's. Someone get the mic away from this guy.
Oh, shit. Everyone just turned off their fucking radio.
Okay,
all right, anyway.
I thought this was the metal experience.
So, Gerard, what is your definition?
That was hard rock.
Difference?
Well, for me, rock. Honestly, like, everybody has their own definition, but mine is actually, like, it's the instrumental. Like, it depends if the bassist is matching up with either the drums or matching up with the guitarist. So, because if you match up with a guitarist, you're kind of just trying to bring out the rhythm more. But if you match with the drums, you're bringing out punch.
Okay.
And that's kind of like, kind of the
big
difference.
That's a good way to look at it.
So, cool. Dave, let's put on some Cannibal Corpse now.
Oh, yes.
Really quick.
Just some to balance it out.
Just to balance it out. Can we do Addicted to Vaginal Skin, please?
Oh, my God.
If you
why even bother?
You just did it all by saying the track title.
That song is sweet.
I can only imagine what that
saying.
Would sound like if that was a hard rock song.
But anyway, since you're
Adrenal just of what it would sound like if you sang Cannibal Corpse as
addicted
like
to vaginal skin.
Oh my God.
That's exactly how it sounded like if you sang it.
But we just got like some arcane knowledge from Gerardo, so you know, the more you know.
There you go.
Could you see if anybody's ever done that before on YouTube? Creed.
What?
Cannibal Corpse cover?
I really don't want to look for that.
Is that a joke?
That's
tons of people have done Cannibal Corpse covers. Why wouldn't you? It's Cannibal Corpse.
In Creed form?
Tyrannus.
Yeah, exactly. You never looked that up, did you? Okay, anyway, Dan. Your turn.
That part, wait, rewind the intro. You got to play the intro. It's the best part.
Yeah.
Turn up.
That knife. And I cut her from her
obviously
neck.
Obviously, nothing's happening.
Oh, my
right
God.
Now.
Down. Tyrannus.
Oh man!
Yeah, man, that's Cannibal Corpse. Woo!
Disgusting.
Oh man.
I like my hardcore.
He's like, and then I ate it.
Oh my God!
Oh man!
That was some heavy shit.
Was that an interview from like Ed Gein? Correct?
I don't know what that's from.
Look that up. Just
look that up and find that out. But
nothing to gain.
I would like to know.
I anyway, can't take you seriously with
you
those
guys whispering back and forth.
He wants chips.
He turns around and looks at me. His eyeballs are bobbling all
his
over.
His eyes behind the bobble eyes are super big. Like he's straining himself to see out of them. He's just
some
got these
poor
huge
man's Harry Potter.
Eyes.
Yeah.
I've been stoned for the past 15 hours.
Let me fix your eyeball. God. Come here.
It's a good look for you. I highly recommend you wear that at all times of the day.
Yeah, I can't wait to take a picture with that. I'm going to have a picture
them.
Of Luca
one
licking
of them's
your
being
eyeball.
Down your nipple.
Luca's going to lick your eyeball tonight.
With a home try to help her on.
No, slinky. Once you break that slinky link
no,
like
wait,
that,
you gotta
it's done.
It's like the telephone
the it's
cord.
It.
It's just got
you
this
broke
kink
it.
In it. You got to
totally,
turn it.
Totally
I don't know.
No, it's totally
enough with the goggles. Enough with the goggles.
Even more
I told
retarded.
You people already. I have a fucking
okay.
disability.
We haven't talked to Dan yet here. Dan, you're
here he comes.
Thing. No, wait. Don't. Oh, no, Lois. Don't go that way.
This is excruciating.
You're supposed to scream. He's playing with your eyeball. Jesus. Oh, it's
about the chip. Hard rock band, I think, would be like Chevelle.
Okay.
I think it's got, it comes down to themes a little bit. Maybe the way they market and how do they interact with the crowd.
Continue, Dan. Continue.
That's all I got.
Oh, that's all I got.
Thank you.
Well, for those that want to call in, it is 773-657-3341.
Don't give them back to them.
773-657-3341.
Rip off.
It's from the dollar store.
Hey, listen, man, I paid 89 cents for those.
See?
Don't break them.
Don't break them. I got a sweet deal, and they close at 9, so I can't get another pair till tomorrow.
Oh, my God.
What's the thing? Oh, there we go.
You never find glasses like that. I got those things for a bargain, man.
Oh, I think he got it. Oh, he got it.
You got to keep playing with it.
Oh,
that's what she said.
Oh, my God.
Morgan, carry the show. I'm
well,
trying to fix it.
Well, listen to some local music. Tonight, we are not doing an unsigned band pick of the week because you guys have actually chosen some of the bands that you guys like from around the scene. We've included a couple of ours. So tonight we're going to highlight Chicago music and unsigned music as much as we can. So let's start with a couple of your guys' picks. What do you want to hear?
Texas Toast Chainsaw Massacre.
Wow, that girl sounded like a bitch.
Yeah.
what song from them?
Dick
Texas
and Balls.
Dick and Balls.
Chainsaw Massacre, Dick and Balls. I have this on my
I'm
iPhone.
Trying to find that. I don't
this is
it's
so
there.
This.
It is
there.
It's
literally
on
YouTube. Super
it's
weird.
It's a
awesome.
Thing.
This song needs to get a fucking Grammy, man. Just and they need to walk out to the music. Just Dick and Balls. Dick and
they're making a sequel. I contacted them
on Facebook.
What is
it called?
Dick and Balls
and
Part 2.
Part 2, the sequel.
The Shaft.
I got the kink out of it.
Oh, thank you.
Now they're nice and saggy.
Ooh.
I mean, it's still jacked up because you bent the shit out of them, but the kink's out of it.
It isn't easy being cheesy.
All right, got it.
All right. Texas Toast Chainsaw Massacre.
Dick and Balls.
Language at Denny's, but not here.
Well, that's too freaking bad. You hear me?
Because we're throwing it back to Morgan and Luco on the Metal Experience.
So we've had some technical difficulties. Dave,
that wasn't technical at
found
all.
Found something else. It's Texas Toast Chainsaw Massacre.
What was
did
that
you
we
play?
Just... Dave, we can't hear you.
Not yet. Pull it up on Facebook.
I've never seen.
That wasn't
it's
it.
On YouTube.
That's why it wasn't too. That's yeah. it.
Dave clicked That's the wrong one.
It. It's got a picture of a guy in the toilet.
Yes.
Yeah, he... There was
okay,
no T
I think we're
toast.
Good to play
it
a song
toast.
Now. Here it is.
T-O-A-S?
We'll try to play Dick and Balls again.
Way to ruin that.
Okay, let's do
let's
it.
Let's try this again.
Hey, wait a minute. You two look kind of familiar. Ain't you them kids that have been whacking off in my tool shed? Dick and Balls, Dick and Balls, Dick and Balls, Dick and Balls, Dick and Balls.
What you just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard. At no point in your rambling, incoherent response were you even close to anything that could be considered a rational thought. Everyone in this room is now dumber for having listened to it. I award you no points, and may God have mercy on your soul.
You're listening to The Metal Experience.
We've assembled a collection of bands who have drummers.
Hard to imagine.
Well, it's easy if you try, Dick.
Now sit back and listen.
A phone charger. And we're back while we look for phone chargers. Now, that was the correct song.
It was hilarious.
Dave, what was it called?
Did I have to charge
but the one we just played?
Time
Dick and Balls.
Here?
Can
yeah.
you say Pretty it one more
sure
time?
Dick and Balls.
Nice and slow.
Can you say
That's what she said.
Dick and Balls.
Dick and Balls.
Sounds like we're on a different radio
now,
station.
Let's say, Rabbi Dave,
what?
You were in front of a church... You're in the front and you're marrying someone and you have to tell them Dick and Balls. How would you
Dick and Balls.
Dick and balls. Nice and straight up.
Dick and Balls.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Dick and Balls. All right. Well, sweet. That was some what was that band again? It was Texas Toast Chainsaw Massacre.
Pretty so creative ingenious. Name. I really love it.
So that's ingenious.
It's really awesome.
That's the next Slipknot right there.
No one can hear you. You have no microphone.
The next future
this
music.
Guy.
The next Slipknot is Dick and Balls. Dick and Balls.
Dick and Balls. Mm-hmm. Dick and Balls.
That's
going to
replace. That's going to replace the Devil and I.
How dare you?
I'm sure.
Dick
I'm
and
sure.
Balls.
Sure.
So step inside. See my Dick and Balls.
Oh my.
Oh my God.
I'm trying to come up with something creative. It's hard to do that.
You're way off.
Good job.
I'm planning on making a parody.
What usually inspires your lyrics, Brandon?
I don't know.
Dick and Balls, Dick and Balls.
I actually like a lot of like dark horror films and stuff.
Like? Tell me 14 of them right now. Your favorites.
Go. Killer Clowns from Outer Space.
All right. I would have to start off with the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. That's one of my favorites. The original one from like 1979.
Eight. Yeah, six.
78.
One of those 3 years.
Yeah.
I know it's one of those 3 years.
It has a number.
The original Freddy Krueger movies. Okay. Nightmare on Elm Street.
Okay.
Obviously.
84.
Yeah. Pennywise, It, Stephen King.
89.
All right. Pet Sematary.
Maybe 91. Pet Sematary is 80, 88, 89, and the second one came out in 91, 92.
Yeah. The trilogy of The Exorcist.
Exorcist is the 70s. I couldn't give you a year, but...
Yeah. The Poltergeist.
Oh, yeah. Those are the 80s. Mid-80s.
Yeah. I Spit on Your Grave. That's a good movie.
That's from the late 70s.
Teeth.
That movie's great.
Yeah. Shazam.
Dude, Teeth, man.
I gave Teeth one star because, I mean... Man, if that was my wiener.
So, you know they're actually making a sequel to it, right?
What?
Yeah.
That movie came out like... 2005.
Shazam is actually one of my.
I wonder if
the sequel going to be called Gums.
I wonder
how many.
I wonder how close I am with these dates. I'm pretty good at getting the. All right, keep going. Keep all going.
Right, here, let me see. Rumpelstiltskin.
Rumpelforeskin.
No, you never seen the horror.
Not version? The porno.
No, I've seen Pumpkinhead.
No, there's a real like a horror Rumpelstiltskin that and like the horror of Pinocchio.
Okay. Oh, yeah, I've seen the little Pinocchio one.
Yeah, dude.
What a little bitch. That's what I don't understand in these horror movies, because it's like, oh, just punt this motherfucker.
Yeah, fucking the original Child's Play, dude.
Boom, we're at 10. Can you give me four more?
Yeah.
You give me four more, I'll give you a hug when we get outside.
All right, for sure. As long as I get that hug. House of a Thousand Corpses, dude.
Boom. Okay, it's 11.
Fucking House of the Dead, Dawn of the Dead, Land of the Dead.
All right, come on. That counts as one. That's all just... Romero.
That's George A. Romero.
It's all best. Romero.
Okay, all right. I'll keep on going. Let me see. Evil Dead.
One more movie.
Evil Dead 2.
One more movie. Evil Dead 2. No, just playing with you. The last one that I would put on there, probably Gothica, dude. Like, Halle Berry was pretty good in that movie.
Gothica.
You never seen that? You're that?
Your 14th was weak as shit.
What about From Dusk Till Dawn? Did you mention that?
Oh, no, I didn't. Hey, what about Queen of the Damned, dude? Actually, that movie is Queen of the Damned.
Equally as terrible, if not worse.
Whoa! Queen of the Damned is awesome.
They had
the soundtrack
best
is
movie
sweet.
Soundtrack.
Absolutely.
The soundtrack was great.
Wayne Static?
Yeah, dude.
Jonathan Davis.
There's a difference between
David
a soundtrack
Draymond?
And a movie.
Really?
Chester
the movie was
Park.
Terrible.
Put your hands together and you got yourself a great piece
great,
of object
yeah.
right there.
That movie's the shit.
Have you... Wait. Are we watching... You guys... Have you guys seen Queen of the Damned? Did you guys
hold on,
Luke,
I just
watched Queen
it tonight.
Damned.
I just
did you guys
it two nights
watch
ago.
The movie?
Yeah, I watched
said
the movie.
You said soundtrack and movie.
It's based off of a comic.
Put your hands together.
It was sludgy.
Graphic novel.
Like, it would move kind of slow. It was sludgy. I didn't really... Soundtrack's badass.
It's pretty terrible. That's I mean that's just
that's it
sense.
Soundtrack's terrible
dude, soundtrack is
hold,
pretty,
hold on
pretty all
right fine what about this last one dude
come on,
fucking the original Last House on the Left dude
with some fucking dick decapitation.
Ugh. Did you ever see that one dude?
Yeah.
That was some solid
and
dick
I've watched the dumbest horror movies
and I've
ever
seen the remake of
I've
course.
Seen the worst
the
B movies with
stupid,
him ever
the original
I'm sick
awesome.
Of it
have you seen the I Spit on Your Grave, the remake?
Yeah, that's the one that I was talking about.
Oh, you weren't talking about the original?
No, I was talking about the new one.
Well, the remake has forced retard rape scene in it that's
oh my God.
Pretty intense. And then the second one, and I Spit on Your Grave 2, it's not too bad.
So, do I still get that hug, man?
Hell yeah.
All right.
Have you guys seen
Tusk
at all?
There you go.
Tusk?
Oh, I saw the picture. Kevin Smith. I saw the picture of Justin Long transformed into like
don't ruin it
like a walrus. It's
a
fucked
walrus?
Up.
Wait, what?
There's a movie
it's
called
Kevin
Tusk.
Smith.
Yeah, Kevin Smith made a new horror
yeah,
movie.
Oh
Tusk.
Yes,
the story behind that's pretty interesting. If anyone out there listens to his podcast beside me, a while ago he had this idea to make a Canadian trilogy, the True North trilogy, which he's calling it now. Which
true
is
true north as opposed to fake or false north.
Exactly. So he was gonna. He was like, okay, if you want me to make this movie called Tusk, use hashtag walrus yes, and that's with all the publicity he got it made, and he's making a sequel based on another thing from his podcast called Yoga Hosers.
Wait, how is it a sequel if he hasn't made the first one?
He already did make it.
It came out like 2 weeks ago.
Just came out. He's already in production of Yoga Hosers.
The Kevin Smith?
Yes, the Kevin Smith.
The guy that made Jay and Silent Bob?
Yeah.
Clerks and
it's pretty much like a graphic parody.
It's a goofy horror movie.
It's kind of like he did it with Red State, too. He took a new direction
with
Red
State. Yeah,
but Red
State sucked, so.
Really?
What is Red State?
I thought that was pretty good.
Essentially, like, these, like, hardcore Christians, like, kidnap these two gay guys, and they're, like, torturing them. And then you, and then the feds are trying to burst in, and then it becomes a switch story about.
Are they trying to burst in, Dave?
Yes, and they're trying to rescue the guys, but they've already killed them. And then you kind of feel bad for the preacher people, but you're not really supposed to. I think I'm not really sure.
And because of Tusk, investors just took a shot at Kevin Smith, and now he's just got financing for Clerks 3.
Yeah, he finally got all his financing together for Clerks 3 out of Tusk.
Hey,
do you see Rosario Dawson's titties in Clerks 3?
Bill and Ted Excellent Adventure 3 being made?
We just watched that the other night, me and Mike.
That's pretty cool.
Pretty stoked about that.
But yeah, and then the last movie of the True North trilogy is going to be, it's called Moose Jaws. It's just Jaws with a moose. So instead of a shark, it's a moose that's eating people.
Sounds so pathetic. Dave.
What?
Oh,
what? What?
Dave, I think you know what time it is. Let's do it.
All right, I guess.
All right, here goes.
Could I speak to the drug dealer of the house, please?
Let's hear it from the soundboard.
Cookies?
Yep, cookies.
Oh, no. No, no.
What do you got, Dave?
What? Because he's eating the chips?
Put them down.
What do you got for us,
put
Dave?
Put down the chips.
Put down the spicy Cheetos.
How are those Dillinger socks, by the way?
They're pretty sweet. I've only worn them once. They're in the dirty clothes pile now.
Gotta clean them.
You should auction them.
Auction off my used.
Yes.
We need to get Jeff in here.
They're like sock number 147.
173 out of 300 that were printed.
Yeah. It's kind of weird. Who makes limited edition
I spent
socks?
Money on those socks.
Well, yeah, obviously. They didn't give them away to for free, but it's just kind of funny that it's like, whoa, man, check out my fucking limited edition socks.
That's how you should be saying it.
That is how I will not be saying it. <They're>
All right.
They're good for weddings, funerals, and work.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll move through this quickly because we got someone on hold. So, Rancid released a new music video for their three songs of
Boo.
Honor is All We Know.
Boo. Dave, your mother's a whore.
Who said that? You guys, these guys, we gotta talk to them.
I've ever seen Dave. Look at you.
Whoa, really?
Whoa.
Oh my god.
He just said he's gonna drop you like a sack of potatoes.
Hey, I'm gonna go get that guy.
Dude.
He just took off.
Just because it's your 3-year anniversary with the show does not mean you just get to talk shit.
You guys
shit
can't
tonight.
Say that stuff to Rabbi Dave.
My god.
Sorry, Dave.
He'll circumcise your ass.
He'll circumcise your wieners.
Brandon's not gonna miss. Dave,
it's okay. He's gone now. I saw him run that way.
And I'll miss.
Don't worry. He said. He's going to apologize. He's going to sit on your face.
There you go. Jeez, guys. Oh, all right, let's keep going. What else all you right. got?
Same thing for they released a date for the Honor is All We Know because Rancid.
New what?
The release date, which is October 27th.
New Rancid?
Yeah, and no one's going to listen to it.
I
want to
hear the new Lamb of God, man.
Oh, my God, me too. Oh, me I'm too. Ready. And that DVD's coming out next month. Yes, I'm so
it.
There. I love them so much.
I do too.
Anyway,
no. I cannot take you seriously with those damn goggles on.
Your eyeballs are clicking together.
The Melvins streamed a new track called Sesame Street Meat.
Hey, I all work right. on Sesame Street.
I do. What else you got, Dave?
I smell like hat.
Okay, so apparently, I obviously shitty joke article, but not to be outdone by some other metal bands announced fragrance lines.
What? There's cologne and stuff out now for bands?
Yeah, apparently Slipknot put out some kind of cologne or some shit like that.
Does it smell like sweat and ass?
According to Clown, it smells like oil and camel shit or something like that.
Oh my god.
Why the fuck would you want that?
I have no idea.
Dude, you smell like shit, dude. Yeah, I just got it from Slipknot.
So here we go. Scent of Motorhead, cocaine and whiskey. Scent of a Slayer, Rain and Blood, Scent of Anthrax, Cow Dung and Burger King, Motley Crue, Used Condoms and Burning Cars, Alice in Chains, Heroin and Rooster.
That one's actually pretty good.
Rammstein, Kerosene and Crusty Vibrators, Shadowfall, how do you pronounce that one? But I can't pronounce that oil.
Sound it out. Use your hands. Clap.
Clap.
You went to school in Sussex, man. Give him a chance.
Patchouli. Oil and Fenway Park.
What?
Petroleum
oil? I don't know.
Oh, petroleum?
Yeah.
Is that even a word?
Yeah, that shit stinks. Tippies.
Butcher Babies, Tits and Ass, Fear Factory, Pizza Vomit and Dorito Farts, Immure, Overheated NES and Ball Sweat, Poison, Hairspray and Botox. Metallica, Smells Good for a Few Hours, Then Starts to Smell Horrible. Kiss, Money, Disturbed, Monkey. Napalm Death, Napalm, Weed Eater, Weed, Anal Cunt, Anus and Vagina, Pig Destroyer, Bacon, Cattle Decapitation, Soy Bacon and Humanure, Cannibal Corpse, Body Odor, and Stridex.
How long is this list?
Pretty long.
It's pretty long.
Is there someone on hold? You're going to name off every single...
Well, that's just...
Move on, Dave.
Yeah. Ozzy and Black Sabbath are going to do one more album and a final tour.
That's what they all say.
Yeah. Well, Ozzy's getting old and he's going to die eventually. So.
Ozzy... Puppy! Is it getting old?
Oh, my God. How the fuck old. Do you wear these?
He's old
Whoa,
as
shit. Whoa, he's fucked with your eyes, dude.
What else you got?
Last thing. Comfy, no, Exodus released a new track from their album Blood In, Blood Out.
Nice.
You look so sterile.
Anyway, so guy on hold.
Who's
I'll put
the
him
guy
through.
On hold?
It's he's from Programmable Animal.
Napalm.
Hello.
Programmable Animal.
What are you? Oh, hello,
hello,
caller. You're on the Metal Experience with One Steel Wound. Who is this?
Hi, this is Joe from Programmable hello? Animal.
Hey, Joe. What's going on, buddy?
Good band.
Well, it's been bugging me a lot, and I've, like, all week, I know last week I was kind of riffing on Dave pretty heavy, so I wanted to say, Dave probably kind of sucks at juggling, and I feel like even if he, like, practiced and trained really hard for a long time, he'd still probably be pretty mediocre, but, you know, honestly, I'd respect him for trying, so, yeah, that's about all I got, guys.
That's all I got.
Are you going to do this every week now? Just call in and rip on one of us?
You say yes.
Joe, you're the best.
Thank you. Good luck at your show. One steel wound. I'll try to make it to the Mojo's one.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Joe, did you have anything else that you just wanted to...
No, that was it.
...let people know that, Dave, if he practiced really hard, he'd probably just be mediocre at juggling?
Yeah, that was pretty much it.
The Insight.
Mojo's October 10th, Joe. Featuring Dave's shitty juggling.
Headline.
Well, what's Programmable Animal doing? Anything coming up?
How'd that show go on Sunday? Sorry we couldn't make it. I really wanted to. Got super late.
Why are you staying in my personal business, Joe?
I bought a motorcycle.
Oh,
you did not buy a motorcycle. You bought a scooter.
It's my motorcycle.
Huge difference.
Don't make it sound cooler.
So, how'd that show go, buddy?
About a ruckus.
The show on Sunday, it was really fun. In fact, the whole festival was like, I met a lot of people there. It was a very cool, big event. A lot of people were there. A good experience overall.
Where at?
I was at the Metro. The show is at a smaller bar.
Oh, cool.
Wow, really cool.
Got to check you guys out.
Yeah, there were a lot of big names there. I think Billy Corrigan was actually there on a Saturday.
What?
Yeah, that's what I heard anyway.
Just hanging out?
Yeah, and Fear Factory was there. I saw, I saw a couple people, talked to a couple people. It was really cool.
Sounds good, man.
You're a funny guy, Joe.
We got to go out for dinner sometime.
Right on.
Last
right
week.
On.
Oh, man.
Any last words,
by
Joe?
The way, Dave, one more thing, Dave. If that was too like devastating, they sell competitively priced off-brand burn cream at the Dollar Tree next door. So.
I love this guy.
Joe, you need to call in more, seriously. Ever since we've had you on the show, you've talked more and more than I think you've ever done in your life.
that could very well be. I haven't been keeping track.
Joe doesn't keep track of how much he talks. Oh, Joe, I love you.
We're all going to have a party with you, Joe. You're going to be the entertainment.
It's okay for guys to like me. It's 2014. You can do what you want.
Man. Nice.
So I guess I got to go. I'll talk to you guys later. Good luck again at your show.
Bye,
guys.
Joe.
Thank you, man. All
right, Joe. Take it easy, buddy.
Bye-bye.
Joe, Dave, I bet if even after you practice for a very long time, you'd still be mediocre.
So there's a couple things that Dave
being a juggler has never,
like,
never been what?
Are you done? Are you done with your segment or no?
Yeah.
Oh.
He's eating peanuts.
How about Veil of Maya just lost their vocalist?
Yeah, he just it was kind of weird.
Yeah.
The funny
picture looked like it. And how about Malcolm Young diagnosed with dementia?
Who? Oh, yeah.
Malcolm Young, AC/DC, he quit. He retired because he now has dementia.
Well, you told me that was Angus that quit.
No, it's Malcolm.
And I was like, Angus is that band.
No, it's Malcolm, and his family just released officially that he is dementia.
It's just dementia, one.
Dementia, whatever. I don't know how to pronounce it.
You don't know how to pronounce anything. How you graduated college is beyond me.
Your lips are moving, but I got nothing.
You'll hear it later.
Nope. I don't listen to shows afterwards.
No, I'll tell you later. I'll tell you later.
My own voice.
She doesn't like her own voice.
A lot of people don't like your voice. It's very common.
It's gross.
Oh my goodness! I think we need to play another song.
I feel you. Yes. Let's hear some music. This dude's craving these whatever crunch shit things are. Crunch cheese curls.
He just had like six burgers.
What the fuck?
I got these for a good price, all right?
Are they called a dollar?
Yeah. You know, I've never tasted other Hot Cheeto products before. So if these are good, I might have to start snagging these.
Living on the edge over here.
I live in Mokina.
On a journey, man.
You don't have the dollar store in Mokina?
No, everybody's rich out there. The only Mexicans that live out there are the ones
Mokina.
That cut my lawn.
I'll Google it for you.
Whoa.
Just beep out that comment. That was kind of...
This guy's Mexican, just so you know.
Everyone listening.
And so is his bassist.
Yeah, I was going to say, you're insulting
I thought you were
man
Italian.
Next to you.
Yeah,
no, according to a lot of dangerous people, I'm Italian.
No, but even then, you're half Italian, half Hispanic.
Someone's here. I think we met.
They heard what you said.
Run.
He's here
They're like, we're taking your motherfucking Cheetos,
cheesy
bitch.
Cheesy curls.
Well, all right. What do you want to hear?
What do you
want to
hear? We've got a
play?
List of stuff that you've given us that we've compiled.
Is it local? Or
some low country.
It's both.
Some low country. Dave,
low
you got that
country.
Song?
Low country.
Hey,
you got that song queued up?
I Grounded. Can't find anything by low country.
Hey, you should put on right now. You should put on Monuments, I the Creator.
Ooh, Monuments! I can't wait to see them with animals as leaders. What?
Dave, is that doable?
No, I got it.
Low country.
I could just imagine
monuments because I can't
hearing this in 5 years.
Yeah, I can't find Low Country.
Oh.
So we're gonna do Monuments by the Creator.
Listen to it 5 years from now, and you're gonna be like, "Man, I remember when I bought those Cheetos for a dollar; they were so good."
Exactly.
Or they're like, "Oh my god, I remember when I bought those Cheetos for a dollar, and the next day I shit out my ass backwards."
Well, I got the glasses too, so I can't really complain.
Well, the glasses were a sweet buy, actually.
Yeah. So anyway, Monuments by the Creator.
Let's do it.
This is the end. I promise.
This is the Metal Experience, and now back to Morgan and Luco.
You've never lived until you put Cheetos in your pockets, right, Dave?
Good so answer.
Anyway,
good what were those answer. Two songs that we heard? We had a 2-4.
A 2-4.
2-4. Why are we laughing like that?
This would explain why.
Hi, Grandma.
We got a new.
Hold on, we didn't announce the songs that we played.
Oh, sorry. What songs did we?
Monuments. I forgot what it was though.
Monuments. What was that song?
Do you remember what we played?
Eye of the Creator.
There it is.
Was that the name of the Monuments song?
Yeah.
What was
that? Then we found Low Country's Grounded. Yay!
That was local too.
Yeah.
That sounded good as fuck.
It's Low Country. Well,
Monuments wasn't local. Monuments is a signed act. Brandon, I can hear you. Move back outside. Hey, thanks.
He's like, I want my eyeballs back.
We've switched out some members here. We brought in the band's friends because Brandon needs to take a little bit of a time out.
Yes.
He's got a very dirty potty mouth. So we very have brought dirty. In...
You guys have yelled cunt on the radio. Now.
That's very
not calling
true.
The kettle black here.
Well, we got now, just...
I would like to say the main reason why he wanted to step out is so he can eat his giant bag of Flamin' Hot Cheetos from the dollar store.
Let's go with that theory. Yeah.
Yes.
Probably. With his mullet.
He's about to get...
He's yelling at people. His
mullet. Is he hailing a taxi or something?
Oh, man. He's got fucking googly eyes and shit.
As he stuffs his
someone's
face.
Gonna
watch
fuck
him
you
bite
up.
That eyeball on accident.
No, he's out there trying to get laid.
Well, that's not gonna happen.
He's on the right track. He's on the right track.
Not with
hey baby, you want some Flamin' Hot Cheetos?
Not with the scent coming out of that ass with those Cheetos and those eyeballs. That's not happening. No.
By the
all.
Way, we replaced Brandon with Jeff. For those that didn't know,
Jeff is our really really good friend.
Not a drug dealer.
Not.
Why is Jeff not in here?
Jeff's right there.
Jeff's sitting right now.
Oh, I thought. Well, then who's the dude behind me?
He's the drug share. Well,
that's Creepy Chris.
His name is
Creepy Chris.
Why no, did we not. Bring Creepy Chris in here and make it weird?
His name's Jumanji. It's not Chris anymore.
He came to stalk you.
Jumanji!
He'll go in the other room out. And hang out with those guys. He can get all creepy and Dave and Bill.
But Jeff is,
Hey guys, I'm Creepy Chris.
Hey, what's up, Creepy Chris?
Jeff is going to school right now, and he's actually, plan on interning at New York City at Def Jam. That's his aspirations.
Def Jam Records. Yeah. You want to manage a rapper and get a bunch of lawsuits?
Hoes and bitches.
No, he wants to get Slayer back on the label, right?
Oh yeah, totally. Yeah.
So what's the plan, Stan?
Jeff.
His name is Jeff.
That oh my god, that's a scene. What's the plan, Stan? I know his name's
it
Jeff.
It wasn't that
duh.
Funny.
It what? Was hilarious.
Well, thanks for laughing, Bill. I appreciate it.
Well, the plan fuck is Sunday too. We're coming to fuck shit up in Joliet, so that's the plan.
Yes.
Well, you'll for sure make it in New York. Good
Sunday,
luck to you.
Sunday, no. Sunday.
Joliet's a ghetto. Move on.
Wow.
Hey, we have never played there before. You leave us alone. I've worked there. Not fun. Shithole.
Sorry.
It's not a shithole. It's got its classy parts.
Yeah. It's not all bad.
Yeah. He's giving me the
to be
fucking
honest,
stare, man.
I've been to Joliet many times, and I've never gone through a bad part of Joliet. Or
really?
At least I no, don't know.
Really?
That looks fine.
No.
It's not like there's
fine
to me.
Hookers been drunk
and crackheads
the
hanging
there.
Out on the street.
There's not a dude getting a blowjob on the side of a road.
Not
yeah.
Not
I've never seen that.
Never.
Never.
I've never seen that.
I've seen it.
I wish I have seen that. Have you
he's
really seen
it.
That?
Yes.
You've seen that?
Yes. Dan experienced
where?
It. What are you talking
Please
about?
Please do tell.
In Joliet.
Pull
in Joliet,
up some blowjob like music stories.
Driving around and you're like, hey, there's a dude getting a BJ from
yeah.
a chick. You're just like,
it's simple as that.
Hey, buddy, how's your blowjob? Well, see you later.
I didn't stop to examine it, but it
Dan
seemed
was actually
as though
giving the blowjob.
It had a bush.
A bush?
And
he
it was
saw
poking
a bush.
Out, yes.
A little bit of a trunk?
A little bit. It was some Mandingo, man.
So you saw this dude's wiener? His drove up, saw this dude's wiener?
I had to take a closer look.
He
I'm
was
sorry,
under a bridge
playing,
at the time.
I'm playing off the music.
You had to double take.
What do you mean? You got to get a closer look like you stopped, got out of your car, and walked over to
I
him?
Saw the whole thing.
You're like,
the,
dude, I got to look at that. Whoa.
The veins and all. Yep.
Oh my! You got
you were
that close
enough to see the veins.
I told you he was giving the blowjob.
Were you? Yeah. Were you the one giving the blowjob? Did you feel the veins too? Jeez.
I felt it with my eyes.
Oh my!
He could feel the power.
Was dick slapping you?
I felt it with my eyes, and then my penis felt it with my hand later. Mental images.
I got nothing to say.
Of Joliet.
I don't know why I asked
that
for him to
image is something I never
elaborate
wanted in my
on
head.
This story.
Thanks, Dan.
It's the music.
Strangers in the
you
night,
really
right, Dan?
Really do deliver the full package.
Ah, that's giggity. What she said. That's what giggity. She said.
So speaking of full package, just reminds harkens back to the days when we'd call up sex shops and ask them for barrels of lube.
Barrels.
What? Define a fucking barrel.
We did call some sex shops back in the day.
Anything bigger than your standard,
yeah,
size
like
lube tub.
Yeah.
Do you think that you could carry a conversation
like
with a
gallon.
Sex shop and ask them weird questions without laughing?
Without laughing, no.
Okay.
No, it
I believe you
well,
could.
It's hard to do.
Can anyone in this room?
Would you like to call them?
I will do it.
Mike, you're up for
I
it.
Could
you
call
think
them,
you
yeah.
could do it?
I
think.
Do it.
Oh, my God. All right, so find a random one. Think really hard on this as to what you're going to ask them.
Okay, when you guys are ready, I'll patch you guys through.
We'll mute all the mics but Mike's.
Okay.
Can you,
Mike, you ready?
Can you put me on? But if I'll just take away if I feel like I'm going to laugh. But
okay.
Mike will be in charge. You'll be in
okay.
charge.
All right, so get ready.
How is this going to work?
Mute all
well,
Mike,
now we're going to find
you're
out.
You're in charge, though.
But if I fuck up, I'll back off.
Hey, we can call him up.
Okay, so you ready?
You're way too
That's
bad.
Exactly what he said. But if I fuck up, I'll back off.
You're in charge.
What, Dan? What am I going to tell him, Dan?
Tell him that we're in a situation. That's why both of us are on speakerphone. And you're inside me.
Oh my
That's
God.
Why we need the lube. You're inside me, all right?
I'm stuck inside of him. I need the lube.
Someone give me a second. Get him out of my ass.
Let's
do it.
I'll
probably tell you to call a hospital.
No cream pie in Dan tonight.
Oh, God.
I don't think they can help you in this situation.
Oh, okay, so you guys ready?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to start dialing up.
I'm tearing up right now. Holy crap.
Oh, I hope I don't fuck this up.
Babe, are you dialing? No, for real. Try to pull it off. Give it like 10 minutes. You guys can do it.
Thank you for calling Pleasure Chest. How can I help you?
Hi, I was wondering if you guys sell the coconut-flavored condoms.
I'm not able to hear you because your phone is breaking up. Can you repeat that one more time?
Do you sell coconut-flavored condoms?
Still can't hear you.
Oh.
I'm calling back.
Do you sell coconut-flavored condoms? Coconut-flavored condoms, do you sell those? I'm in desperate need of coconut-flavored
He's
condoms.
He's in my ass!
I can't get out!
Don't ignore us.
I think she hung up, dude. Yeah, she's gone, man. Oh my God. We
Could
need to retry
she,
this.
Do you think she really couldn't hear us?
I think
Probably.
So.
Probably.
Maybe, yeah.
I'm not entirely sure if she couldn't hear you because I can hear you just fine, but...
She let's, wanted us to call
let's
back.
Let's try though. It again.
Oh, do you want to try a different shop?
But a different shop.
Sure,
different
yeah.
shop.
Okay.
More classy.
I got to pick one.
Search classy sex shops.
Classy.
He's
There's
got.
No such thing as
you're
class.
Envisioning what you want, and you're like, I want the classiest sex shop.
They have to be wearing tuxes when they sell me yeah. stuff.
Yeah. So are we talking Igor's Dungeon here? classy sex shop.
Oh, I got the bottle of salsa. I could use that for sound effect.
What are you going to do with that?
Oh, no.
Finger it? What else would you do?
You going to, like, slosh it around with your finger?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Let's. Can I pick it up? No.
That would sound really weird. Like, sir, your bony fingers are blasting against something. And then
give
the
it away
chip.
By eating the chip.
Sir, like, are you eating? Oh, are you eating chips? No, we don't have coconut flavored condoms. But
no.
You have chips.
Did you find the classy one?
I'm looking at a few of these. I'm just trying to pick one. Is the hard part.
Settle for subclass if you have to.
Subclass. Subclass.
We settled for subclass on this one. Dave's typing. Enhance.
Gerard, how's your YouTube cover of the negative one?
Pretty badass. I like it.
Enhance.
Cause I saw it's got a grand views.
I know. I'm doing good.
Enhance. He gave it 110%
in the ass.
Huh? What do you think of the new bassist since Paul? He's
all right. All right. I mean, so our victim is a lover's lane.
Yes.
Yeah. Let's do this.
Can you guys hear me on this? You guys
all mics off.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah.
All right.
What's going on?
Let's see.
No, well, it's only 9 o'clock.
Let's take it up a notch. Call a dominatrix, please.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
And give me the address.
Call up one of those dungeons.
Would somebody politely ask Morganist what places she's talking about?
Do you really not know about these places?
No, what?
Those are places?
Those
like
are places?
Dominatrix places!
Yes, type in dominatrix dungeons in
Tell
Chicago.
Me,
you sound like you've done this before.
How do you not know what that is?
I've
they play
known
dominoes
some people
there.
To be in the BDSM community.
Yeah,
yes.
They play dominoes.
No, they don't.
And they wear strap-on foot-long hot dogs.
What?
Foot-long what?
You want me to ask for those?
They eat hot dogs.
We found a place for dungeon rentals.
What? You can rent a dungeon?
Yes, you can.
Chicago dungeon rentals.
Ask yes. Call that shit.
So you need to ask. You need to ask those questions.
Now. How are they cleaned? Do they have semen on the walls?
I'm gonna ask for.
Can I get someone semen on the walls?
Yeah. Exactly. Oh, this place looks great.
I'm gonna ask if they have pre-ejaculated semen on the walls.
Oh my god. Like, now, do I have to put my own?
Oh yeah, I'm gonna be serious.
Now I have to put my own semen on the walls.
Oh, there's no phone number.
What?
There's no phone number for this dungeon place.
There's no phone number.
You have to email them to inquire for rates.
Email them. Do I have to put my own semen on the
walls? I
mean,
that can't be the only place in Chicago. Excalibur, the nightclub that's now Castle, used to be a dungeon down below.
Wow. It is haunted.
Yeah, it is haunted too, but it used to be a dominating place.
Hey, it's haunted down here, but you want to put semen on our walls?
God damn it. No. There's some spooky cock. Spooky cock.
Hey, there's a ghost. I better go try and have sex with it.
Oh, shit.
Oh, God. Someone's calling back.
Someone's calling
us. Answer it as a sex shop. This is Stevie's sex shop.
Slammer radio.
Damn it.
Oh, damn.
Stevie's butt loving sex shop.
Is it the sex shop? Was that the sex shop?
That might have been. But we got a contact number for
Stevie's butt loving.
We got a contact number.
Just
we're gonna
dial.
Call
oh my god, these are for mistresses.
Ooh.
Oh shit.
Yes.
Dave,
this will work. Okay, we have
when
options.
They answer. I just
He's
need
dying.
You to play AC/DC's "All I Want for Christmas is a Mistress," but it needs to be timed up perfectly.
I can't.
Can it, like, come in slowly?
Wait. Which mistress do you guys want? We got
Christmas
Simone, Xena, Alexandra.
Xena.
Warrior Princess?
Oh, my God.
Xena, okay. The Warrior Princess?
We'll ask her if she'll, like, film us and spank us while we do most of the work.
Oh, my God.
Okay?
You know she's going to say yes because you're paying her.
Yeah, but we'll talk her down.
I'll ask if she'll do very disturbing things for low prices.
She ain't doing nothing.
Oh my god, okay.
I want to do everything.
Are you guys ready?
We need her presence.
You guys ready?
Wait, so what is this all about?
Have fun.
Have fun.
Well, yeah, that's
like you never called one.
Well, yeah, I've never called one.
Don't fucking lie to us.
You are pretty handsome. Let's go.
Thank you.
Are you guys ready for this?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm just going to spitball this.
J Rock. Trailer Park Boys.
So, what do you guys want me to ask?
Yeah, know what I'm saying?
She's a dominatrix? Or a mistress? Is it the same thing?
Why don't you ask?
Yeah. Hi, I've never done this before, but I was wondering if you offered high-quality dominatrix services.
There's a lot of static. What is your question?
Can you hear me now?
A little bit.
You can't hear me?
Who are you?
My name is Ron, and oh, fuck. I'm in a real bind right now. I need some high-quality dominatrix services ASAP.
High quality? What are you talking about? High quality? Be specific.
Like just as much torture as possible.
As what?
As. Oh, what was that? I'm sorry. My client is asking me if he can ask.
I could barely hear you. Give me a call back, okay?
No.
Do you have 8 balls of coke?
Coke, man. Come on.
Dude, come on. We're fucking blasted up here. Give us some horny bitches.
Do I have to put my own semen on the walls?
That was awful.
Why don't you just
all connect?
I hung up, and I don't know why. It's never done this bad before. I can't stop fucking laughing.
Should we call off somebody's phone in here and put it on speaker?
That's probably better.
And you want to give that a shot? Go ahead.
That's probably a lot better.
Let's do that.
Yeah, we'll find some numbers. We'll put them on speaker. Yeah. All right. We'll call them to their phone.
We'll do Bill's segment first.
So right. Let's put on
Do
some.
Do I have to put my own semen on?
Let's play some victims.
It doesn't
let's
get
play
old.
Some air raid. Then we'll be back.
I thought we were doing Bill's segment first.
Yeah, let's do that, and then we'll play some music, and then we'll figure out our lives.
And now for a random moment with that guy Bill.
Don't understand what you said, but I'm gonna sit down.
Only on the Metal Experience.
I am punching your son.
I am punching salads, guys.
I am punching your salad.
They should recognize that track.
Do you guys recognize that track?
I do not.
Wasn't they that suck. Sadistic by, like, Once Two Wound?
I think so. No, it couldn't be. No.
Bullshit. What do you got for us, Bill?
Well, I figured I'd give you a little insight as to what happened in my trip in Nashville.
Absolutely. Oh. Don't answer it, Dave. It's a trick.
It's a trap.
Is it the sex
trap? It's a trap.
Answer it, Dave.
Answer it, answer
homoerotic
it, answer it.
Love fest room.
Holy shit, she called
me. Yes! Dude.
Yes! No way.
Come on. Tell her.
She's really calling back.
Tell her you reach the Reitz residence.
Nah, I'm done.
Hey, this
don't
is...
Answer, no, we're just going to let it go. Right.
Nashville, Bill. What happened in Nashville?
Well, Nashville was quite fun. I was at Rocket Town. We had a giant event by Evolution Music.
Rocket Town?
Yes, Rocket Town.
Okay. Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
Reds played there.
Yeah,
before,
there. I was with them. Oh. G Money was with me.
He's freaking out right now.
Why are you freaking out? It's just a phone call.
You think the cops are coming for you, Dave?
They're coming for Creepy
like
Chris.
They're gonna
make
trouble.
You put your own semen on the walls?
It's okay. If you need a hug, I'm right here with you.
It doesn't go to any type of answering machine, does it?
Oh, God, no. Does it?
No.
No. Anyway, Rocket Town. So it was really cool.
Rocket Town was fun. The whole trip was about a 7-hour drive out there, sucked. Which I just kind of pounded through in one night.
You pounded it real hard.
No pun intended.
Nope. No, all the puns intended.
Cockroaches.
Yes, yes.
What that
so
means.
After the whole event, me and Gerard go towards the hotel room because we're going to crash. Mm-hmm. Me and G-Money.
Mm-hmm. Don't know what you said, but whatever.
I don't know what you said, but I'm going to sit down.
I don't know what you
said.
You
cannot be feeling this.
No, so Gerard and I, we go to the hotel because we're going to crash because we've been working all day and we were up driving all night. So We go into the room.
Working all day, even driving home.
And there were cockroaches all over the place.
Ugh.
High quality.
High quality.
High quality. High quality stuff.
What? Now, what did you mean by high quality?
Like, they were a good size. They were huge. What do you mean by
high quality? Peter, calm down.
Whoa, whoa. Listen. I love talking on the radio. I just, you know, yeah. I just like talking. All right.
That really grinds my gears.
Does it?
Yeah.
I'm done.
Wait, roaches in a hotel room don't grind your gears?
So, what do you mean? Like, they were on the bed? And they were
bed, like, bathroom, walls.
You didn't stay there, did you?
No, fuck no. At that moment, I was like, yeah, we're just going to drive.
I ran like a five-year-old girl.
Did you get your money back?
That we had to talk to Expedia about, because we booked it through Expedia. And the hotel couldn't give us the money because we paid Expedia. Expedia pays the hotel.
Like, listen, I showed up. And there were roaches.
Oh, we got, like, formal statements and everything. Apparently, it's not a new problem for them. They have an exterminator.
Did you not look this up on Google before you showed up there?
It was a last-minute thing.
It was, like, the only hotel available. That entire weekend, there was
Comic-Con.
There was Comic-Con.
Probably why it was the only hotel available.
There was Comic-Con. There was a marathon. There was our concert. There was a college football game. We were kind of screwed.
Oh, yeah. But Nashville is tiny.
Mm. Yeah, you could go to, like, the end of the street and look down the block and see the end of the city.
Is it worse than Savannah or Thompson?
Not worse than Thompson. Nothing's worse than Thompson.
But everybody's really polite. I mean, as soon as we pulled into the concert venue...
Hey, we got cockroaches, but they're friendly.
No. Here, listen to this. We pull into the parking lot. We just got there after 7.5 hours of driving. Pull in. Homeless guy walks up to us. Hey, welcome to Nashville.
Where are you guys from? Yeah. Oh, I'm from Chicago.
Get the fuck away from me, bum.
And that's when we said, you know, at this point, back at home, we would have been robbed by now.
Sure. Bums are nice people.
He's like, well, before we rob you, we introduce ourselves. Now we'll rob you. Welcome to Nashville.
My name's Billy the Bum. Give me your fucking wallet, asshole. We got semen on our walls here.
That's a plus.
Let's do some music.
Let's do some music.
Dave, what were we going to play?
Tell me, Dave. Air Raid.
Some Electric Six.
Some Tears of Shit.
Electric Six.
All right. And what else are we going to play?
Then we're going to play some Victims.
What Victim song?
What Victim song?
Dave, tell me. Tell me now. Tell me. Dave.
Spoken Slander.
Yep. Spoken Slander.
Spoken Slander.
Let's fucking do them.
Nothing will come out. Not even turn away from me.
I cannot stand this any longer. As I sit here on the john, nothing happens and my pain is growing. I begin to cry. Eventually I weep. But my tears, they smell funny. Tears stream down my face. But these tears are brown and red. I am crying, king of shit. I am crying, king of shit.
expect that type of language at Denny's, but not here. Well, that's too freaking bad. You hear me?
Because we're throwing it back to Morgan and Luco on the Metal Experience.
So the videos that we are going to post later on our website.
Why didn't it just—it's like frozen.
Oh my god!
My phone's
it's
like
going
too
to
retarded. To...
Hilarious. But we're back. This is the Metal Experience. I'm Morgan Danielle. We are sitting here with Luco the Stashless Blaze, Rabbi Dave, that guy Bill,
check,
guys in One Steel Wound, and we are back to trying to prank call sex shops, dominatrixes, whatever
some quality
we can
stuff.
To make it so weird. We're making it weird tonight. So Mike has taken down some numbers to call
with
his own phone. Where we'll be able to fully hear.
Okay, yeah, actually, you can. Mike,
and
just plug it into the aux cable.
And pass it over to Mike. So,
and
Mike,
we'll walk you
who are you going to be calling? Who is first on your hit list?
Tulip.
Tulip.
Tulip. That's the name of the shop.
Wow.
Can you hear me?
Can we hear? Are,
yeah, so you're going to be able
I
to hear.
I can't hear the mic, that's all.
Oh. Yeah,
what the hell was that? That
microphones.
Was music.
Are you sure we're on?
Yeah.
No, I can hear the mics.
Oh, it's calling now.
All right, everybody shut up. Mike talking to the phone when they get...
Philip Soy Gallery.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi, how's it going?
Hello? Hello?
Hello? Hello? Hello? Hello?
Did they hang up?
Is there anybody there?
Jesus fucking...
Wait.
We are not good at this.
Okay, one more chance.
That's it.
Wait, Mike. Remember, you got to talk into the phone, not the mic.
Okay, put it on speaker.
Remember,
no,
the phone closer
you,
to the.
No,
the
you don't. You don't have to put it on speaker.
Why don't you just take out the aux cable, put it on speaker, and just like lean in?
Oh,
see, you guys are thinking as a team now. There you go.
There's the man.
All right, is it on speaker?
The bearded man.
Be sure to have the mic close.
I hope they call you back at all times of the night.
Good.
Gallery.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing quite well. I was just calling to see if you guys sold like very high quality leather apparel for some freaky shit.
We have some things, but like, are you looking for more like harnesses?
Yeah, the, you know, the more freaky, the better, I guess.
Do you have, I'm sorry.
We have high quality dragon tails.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but they have before you answered, they have to be men's size. It's for me. This is my boyfriend Terry calling. This if it could be men's sizes, that'd be preferred. Collars, if you have them, and ball gags, if that's what you call them.
Yeah, we have some high quality collars. We have a sweet one that's black and white.
That'll look $65. Nice.
Thanks,
we have
Gabe.
Black and red. We have ones with D rings. We have leather cock ring, leather cock stretcher.
Ooh.
We have dragon tails. We have vloggers.
Ask if they have anal beads.
Actually, the Lakeview, the Boys Town location, has a bit more than the Andersonville.
And are you located in Chicago?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're in Andersonville, and we have one in Boys Town also.
Okay, because we've been calling up all night, and this might be a shot in the dark here, but my babe here, he has a Prince Albert, and is there anything we can hook up to that, if you know what that is?
There's pretty much anything you can hook up to it, because anything with the ring, you can attach to anything.
Great. That really gets my rocks.
We'll
babe,
be
hang
in
up
there
the phone.
Soon.
We gotta fuck.
No, hey, come on.
Come on, man.
Let's be
I'm sorry. We'll be there in 45 minutes if you're still open.
See ya.
Fuck my ass!
You guys play a pr- pretty convincing gay compliment.
I couldn't even listen to half of that because I'd be laughing way too goddamn hard.
I have a different opinion of you two now. Together.
Why do you have to put your fucking
hand
up?
Your hand was on it the whole time.
I'm a method actor.
He got into the moment.
That.
He has to make it real.
So
he's a method actor.
So now, if you guys are willing to wait around, I will just...
I asked what a dragon tail was.
I was curious, actually.
No,
you should've.
No, if you guys... Well, fucking Morgan's talking. Anyway, no, if you guys want to wait around after the show, I'll try to cut that clip. I'll check the timestamp right now where we're at. And I'll cut it out. I'll put it like you can put it on your phones or whatever.
That works. Fuck yeah, dude.
Oh, he'd wake up every morning to.
He took it completely serious when I was like, "Is there anything I can hook up to?"
He said, "We have a pretty sweet collar." He was very excited.
He
about
was
that.
Like, "You can pretty much hook anything up." To
eyes
that.
Open up really wide. And he was like, "Oh my god!"
Dan's like, "This is a whole new world
what?
For me. I may be gay."
You know, no joke.
This feels right.
Cock stretcher, I think they said, right?
Cock stretcher, yeah. We've got cock stretchers.
Oh, man.
Should have asked him for sounding equipment.
I think we scored gold when I asked him about the Prince Albert.
No, if you guys want to make that Prince Albert a reality, I am dating a piercer, so.
Really?
Yes.
You want to pierce your cock?
I'm down. Just kidding. I'm down.
Stay tuned for our next YouTube video. One Steel Wound takes a Prince Albert trip.
Fuck. For Mike, ladies.
Only Dan one Reese. Person. I'm not in that. Ow.
No,
we'll all be there.
She does need guinea pigs, so if you guys want your nipples pierced.
She does what?
I said if you need she needs guinea pigs.
I'm not Lars.
Yeah,
My girlfriend's a piercer, but she needs...
Why would you share this information with us on air, Dave? This is your girlfriend.
Because it's funny.
Because it's funny.
If you're a piercer, you're going to see a lot of shit.
Because it's
She's totally for it. She needs people to test piercings on.
Listen, I've seen a lot of shit.
Seen a lot of things back on my day.
So moving on, guys. You guys wanted to talk about that new album?
Hell yeah.
So it's a new album. How many tracks is playing on having on this bad boy?
Got 8.
Yeah. Well, 10.
Getting kind of close to Dan now, huh? We're very comfortable in this situation.
We got a title for the new CD?
Yeah, actually, Dan came up with it. Pretty badass.
Oh, my God. Is it called Cock Stretcher?
You know what? They wouldn't approve of that. I was thinking about Eat My Ass 2014.
Dragon Tail Cock Stretcher.
But we settled with...
I love Dragon. It.
We settled with Vendetta.
What was that creepy look you just gave Bill? What am I missing?
Oh, yeah, we're playing.
I've seen a lot of things going on with you, Dan, tonight.
Morgan
we'll post some videos. I do suspect something's wrong with you.
Morgan.
You're like, you're right, probably a little bit off.
I'm a little bit off.
No,
really?
He's sane.
It's just some extra flavor, and Mike needs to grow out that mustache, and we'll have a flavor saver.
That's how people sang back in the 90s.
Yep. And then boats sank. What we're listening to Celine Dion.
You know,
actually,
we had a van that didn't have any air conditioning or had heater or had have a
and
heater.
It only had one tape in it that worked, and it was
but
Celine
no,
Dion.
Actually, after one of our shows, we were all freezing so much that Dan started cuddling with everybody.
Well, there you go. That's nice.
It was heterosexual.
Yeah,
dude,
that's to survive.
It's a life and death situation, right? Right.
Yes, it is.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
The smallest guy in the group, you had to make the best blanket possible.
You know what?
It was totally heterosexual.
You had to take
right
off all
up
your clothes
he
and
it
sacrifice
out.
Your body for the warmth of others.
You'd
right?
be surprised what limbs I can squeeze between being this small,
dude. Do you guys remember the
you
show?
You have Dave very interested, by the way. Can you go caress Dave and show him an example of what you can do with your body?
Your nips hard yet? Because they will be. Let's see those shit.
Go caress Dave down.
Mike's going to sing us sing us off into the sunset.
Sing, my heart will go on.
You ever dance with the devil in the moonlight?
You know sing
it? But yeah, I would do it a different way, obviously.
No.
You got it?
No, I don't get it.
Whoa, you almost broke that whole entire shit.
Whoa.
Imagine that the whole fucking
Here's
window broke.
Here's Bill.
Is this music playing on the air right now?
Yeah.
That's fucking badass.
We're just about to get to the chorus.
Stop it.
We're
gonna
sing along
with this.
There you go, Mike.
Stop it.
Show us what you got.
Don't do
that. Those high notes.
I'm here for you.
Oh, shit.
I'm here for you.
Don't do that, Jesus Christ!
Oh,
you're
man.
Gonna get me killed.
This is a great movie.
Out of here!
Yeah, he's.
Oh, Billy.
Hello. Hello.
Okay.
Some sobbing, thanks, sad Dave. Sex. Just
crying Jim Carrey.
I got
oh,
it.
So,
so this album, if you could describe it with one word, Gerard, what would it be?
Sexy.
Crazy.
Just one word? Can I say two?
You can say two if you butt in my ass.
Crazy sexy?
Huh?
Crazy sexy? Combine our words. You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
So in two words, how would you describe the new album?
Pretty badass. Actually, it's three words, but who cares?
Actually, badass is one badass word.
There you go.
Yeah,
that's there you go. There you go.
You got it. Boom.
Boom.
You win!
Boom, headshot.
Boom.
And when can we expect it to be done?
It's actually in the mastering process right now. The producer is actually sending us clips as he's doing it, trying to keep us in the loop. It's one of those things where after we finish recording, he's just going to continuously be like, well, you know what? Listen to this now. And then we just get mind blown, like always. So it's
and where are you guys fucked. Recording this at?
He did. It's top secret, but you know, it's a nice little place.
It's a tree fort. You have to go to the trunk. There's an elevator. You go down.
It involves a lot of passcodes.
Mm-hmm. There's actually a screen
swiping,
door.
Finger swiping. You got to do a lot of things to get in. This
urine
place.
Test
to get through the screen door.
So is it in Mike's basement?
No,
not Mike's.
I don't have a basement.
It's in some Citadel tunnels.
Where?
Citadel tunnels.
What?
Citadel tunnels.
Is that a word?
It's in Brazil.
You're weird.
Whoa.
All right. I really wanted to hear Mike sing My Heart Will Go On by Celine Dion. I was ready for those high notes. Top that one, Brandon.
I like how Dave's got it on cue. Oh, yeah, I got that bitch on back burner.
Hit him with that Disturbed. What?
I can't scream this.
Do it. He doesn't even know the words.
Then make it up. Chorus.
Scream it.
All right.
No, don't do
it. I don't know where it is.
You don't know the words.
Oh, I will die. I don't fucking know, dude. All right.
You don't know fucking Celine Dion lyrics?
Nope. I didn't. My heart will go on.
Oh, my God.
We're too loud. We
I scared her.
We need to listen to.
That's why I like screaming.
Yeah, scared really her and blew out her eardrums.
All right, we need to play a couple more.
See, that's why
more tracks and music.
Yeah. What else we got on that list, Dave?
We got some stuff from Age of Aries.
Typo Negative.
What?
We should put Typo Negative on.
No,
the
they're
roots.
Not a local band.
Age of Aries and what else?
Typo Negative is not a local band, and they're not even that good.
And they're not even alive anymore.
Yeah, I don't. Peter Steele's a badass.
You had Unforgiven He's Enemies dead. On the list?
Yeah, we got that.
Well, let's do those two.
Okay.
Let's do it.
family fate. Through the reach of murder under false pretense. Blind the one to a cell and they just
And now, back to the metal experience.
Did you say hookers and blow?
No, I said the metal experience.
That's not nearly as good.
Fuck no! Will you wear the blood? No, no. Follow ya. Oh, yeah.
Well, I,
are we coming back in?
We were just at the Illinois border. Oh. But I had to get rushed to St. Louis.
Well, we just came in the middle of the story. Sorry about that, folks. We got
Brandon has a card
sidetracked there. It was I was brutal.
Brandon dodging bullets.
Crazy motherfucker.
Oh, other band.
What was that band that we played?
What were the two bands we just played again?
We had Unforgiven Enemies. Or Unforgiven Enemies, sorry. No S at the end.
Which one was first and which one was second?
That was the second one.
Unforgiven Enemy.
Is that the band?
Yeah.
I think that was Jeff's idea, actually. I think I remember him saying that when we were outside to play.
That's nice. A good-ass fucking
so,
band.
Yeah,
some
good.
Why don't we fucking
that.
Play a show with them?
Let's hit them up.
Ask him where they are. Well, it's about that time. I can't really hear my sweeper, but I'll make do.
Do we
play
have
that
to?
Shit.
Do we have to, though? I mean, no one will notice.
She can't hear.
Can't hear.
Hey, what's up? I'm Rob Salem, host of The Forge, the home of the best underground rock and metal the Midwest and beyond has to offer. The Forge airs weekdays at 1 p.m. Eastern, noon Central, and streams free from RadioFreeKokomo.org. Make sure that your speakers are cranked to 11 when you tune in, because you're going to hear all the killer neck-wrecking, ear-shattering, face-melting, local and regional rock and metal that I can find. And you're only going to hear it on The Forge at RadioFreeKokomo.org.
Hey, this is the Q-Shirt, and I'm going to slam these two beers while Morgan gives you the local roundup, brought to you by the Chicago Metal Alliance. So sit down, shut up, and make sure you check out the metalexperience.com. We love you, Morgan!
The local roundup with Morgan on the Metal Experience.
All right. Eventually, I promise we will put those two clips together and we'll have one clip. Dave, work on that, please, for me for next week so we can do something about the length of that.
No.
Hey, thanks. Love you guys, too. You're awesome. I know I can kind of hear Bill saying, no. Fuck you, Morgan, not listening to you. Yeah.
No, he said none of that, but continue.
All right. Well, Hatestorm Annihilation is still looking for a bass player. I don't know why, but you guys should definitely try to hit them up. Your big head, your melon, put that away, Luco. Come on. Disrupting the Abacus, looking for a keyboardist and backup vocalist, hopefully in the same person, so hit them up. Bleed for the Fallen is still auditioning vocalists. Return to Flesh needs a bass player, and All the Way Alive needs a bassist and a drummer. So that's the Who Needs Who. Maybe I should call that segment Who Needs Who. That's good. Keep that.
Who?
So congratulations, Keith from Grace the Damned got married this weekend. Congratulations,
congrats,
Keith.
Congrats, motherfucker.
Central Illinois Metal Fest has announced that they will be back next year, bigger and better. That happens in Champaign, Urbana. All those awesome bands flock to Central Illinois for a huge Metal Fest. I think it's like 3 days. So for those that haven't been to it for the past couple years because it hasn't been around, you can plan next year now. So congratulations.
Boom, there you go.
Cryptic
Nothing
Ending.
Nothing else matters.
The
Ebola virus.
Are you done?
I'm good.
Okay, cool. A Cryptic Ending, the melodic hardcore band from Spokane? I don't fucking know. Washington? What?
Spokane.
Okay. Spokane, like cocaine, but Spokane.
Okay.
All right. Anyway, Washington have their CD Goodbye to a Perfect World available now on their Big Cartel page for $10. You can pick that up, and then they are gearing up to record their next full-length album already to help celebrate their upcoming 10-year anniversary. That happens next June. So check them out. Cryptic Ending from Spokane.
Spokane.
Washington. A Burning Empires, the progressive metalcore band from Ontario, Canada, have just released their latest music video on YouTube called Delusion. Also, check out their EP, The Everless, available now on iTunes, Bandcamp, and Big Cartel. Cognizance, the technical death metal band from Yorkshire, UK, have their new lyric video out for The Succession of Flesh. It's off their upcoming EP, In Septum, and you can check it out on YouTube, and MetalInjection.com just featured it. It features a guest solo on guitar from Ile, the guitarist from Doff, and
what?
Frank Mullen from Suffocation.
What?
Vocals. Mm-hmm.
Whoa.
Okay, you're really exaggerating now, hardcore. So with Lion Eyes, the metal band from La Plata, Maryland, have just released their new EP, Incorruptible. And then the Decision EP is also available on their YouTube, iTunes, Spotify, and more. Wherever else they have music sold, they have those up there. So you can check their video out that they just released on YouTube from their recording of their upcoming album, Level Headed, in March. And the new album is to be released very soon. So both EPs you can pick up right now off of various different sites. Valleys, the progressive melodic metal band from
progressive
Clayton.
Melodic metal.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right.
From Clayton, North Carolina, have just released their EP Reborn. It's up on their YouTube and Bandcamp page. Check it out on full streaming. Kissing Candace, the electronic metal band from Long Island, New York, have just released their new EP Conjured. It's off of their website, iTunes, and Facebook page for download. Having fun there, Brandon? Yeah.
He's rocking out.
It's rocking out. Breathing Theory, the metal band from Orlando, Florida, have their EP Parasite up on iTunes right now. And online, they have a shirt design contest available for fans. What they're asking for is for people to be creative and see what everyone comes up with.
Stick figures.
How they said is, wouldn't you love to see your art on some of our official band merchandise worn by fans all over the country?
Stick figures.
Show us what you've got. We are not picky about color schemes, black shirts, white shirts, red, whatever. Post your images right here on our Facebook page for everyone to see, like, and comment. We're excited to see what some of you come up with. Be sure to sign your art. Winner gets their own shirt, obviously, and a copy of their brand new EP when it's released. They'll choose a winner in November. So if you've got some awesome designs, hit up Breathing Theory on Facebook and share it with them. Am I missing
something?
Stick figures. All right. Victims of Contagion, the brutal tech death metal band from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, have released their EP, A Parasitic Unborn. You can stream it off Bandcamp and purchase it off Bandcamp and Facebook.
Yeah? What else you got?
I feel like you guys, what are you guys doing?
They're doing YMCA.
Oh my god, super weird. So check Victims of Contagion out. Fight to Survive, the melodic hardcore band from Worcester, Massachusetts, just released their debut EP, Survive. The link to download you can find on their Facebook page and for any donation of your liking on Bandcamp. We Sunk the Mayflower, the post-hardcore electronic metalcore band from Chowchilla, California, have just released their first and last EP. Warnings in Reflections on their Bandcamp page. The band is calling it quits, but the band members are continuing music in their other projects. One of them is called In All Actuality, and the other one is called Searching for a Sign. So check both of those bands out. Upcoming, tomorrow we are going to be at Mojo's. We are seeing False Hope Fades. Thanks to them for selling us the tickets. Anti-Mortem is playing. We interviewed Zane from them weeks ago. Well, Zane, the guitarist, we interviewed him a couple weeks ago with Birdie. So we're finally going to meet Anti-Mortem. And then Butcher Babies is headlining. So that should be interesting.
Oh, man. I'm just going to look at their boobies and that's it.
Yeah, that's about all they're good for.
You're a piece of
no,
me.
I know they don't. But yeah, we'll be there on Wednesday. On Friday, we have backstage passes to meet Beartooth. Pretty excited about that.
Yeah.
That is my guilty pleasure.
Have you guys ever heard
of them?
What's that band called with those ladies?
Butcher Babies?
Butcher Babies, have you ever heard them?
We moved on to Beartooth.
They sing?
Their music, their music's really good, and they got really good screaming voices and clean
their
singing voices.
Their lyrics are terrible.
Their lyrics are like the worst shit I've ever heard.
Hey, you do know that the girls from Butcher Babies, one of them is a porn star, right?
I mean,
I don't really dig them.
That,
like
I
mean,
I believe I blew them off for the rock star tech.
They, I don't understand. They have like the worst lyrics I've ever heard.
Well, anyway, moving on.
I can't even think of how terrible they are.
We'll be at Beartooth. Like, it'll make up for it on Friday. Then we will be at the Evil Dead musical on Saturday night.
Ooh. With our arms wide open.
They'll definitely not be singing that. And to recap, this past weekend, we were at the Great American Nightmare in Villa Park. We saw Rob Zombie play on Friday.
Mm-hmm.
Went through his awesome haunted house that was very well done. I'm not going to give a lot away, but I was very entertained. And
Morgan cried.
I did not cry, okay? I did not
cry.
Cried. No, I did not. You're full
I
of
cried.
Lies. Okay, there we go. Now the truth comes out. But
I peed my pants.
We suspect we have seen the very last Devil Wears Prada show ever. They are probably breaking up.
Yes. Their live show on Saturday was very
Let's just say it included the vocalist throwing a temper tantrum on stage, throwing his microphone, hitting all the speakers, throwing around their banners that are set up on their stage.
Ripping them off and throwing them
on
the ground.
Having the guitarist glaring at him and missing half of his cues to sing.
Classy.
So Devil Wears Prada is probably never going to be around anymore.
I don't know. It was really weird.
It was very awkward to watch.
They had their time.
He literally threw his mic across the whole entire stage.
You heard it drop. Yeah.
It was like, what is this guy doing? He's like, you want to hear one more song? And then they start up and he throws his mic across the stage.
Yeah.
It's like, well, there's the first verse gone.
Yeah.
All right.
And then it went straight to chorus. So you knew something was wrong when it was continuing, trying to make do.
It was very weird.
Did you ever see the Billy Joe Armstrong one at the iHeart Music Festival?
That guy's a bitch.
Oh, yeah, I did.
He whipped the he broke
that
the guitar
one was
on
right
stage.
On, though. The Devil Wears Prada is garbage.
Yeah.
Well, regardless. And to wrap up local roundup, we have new stickers thanks to Bob the Printer.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks. Bob awesome. The love them. So we are handing out stickers again, and they are yellow font. They're
yellow
awesome.
And black.
So check them out.
Black
they
and
do
yellow.
Awesome
just like my
work.
Soul.
Alliance
Holy
Printing.
Shit. Be in darkness.
Great.
Sorry.
Great Continue. Deals. Bob the Printer is awesome. Check out Corey Rocks Your World on Sundays, Sonic Asylum Radio. And then check out the Metal Deli with Kimmy Monday nights. She's doing awesome stuff, playing a lot of bands and doing interviews as well. And then we have everything up on our website, metalexperience.com. All the unsigned band picks, every band that's been on our show. Links to everyone that we are affiliated with and more. And we're still looking for people to submit those clips to use as sweepers. I don't know why we haven't gotten any. It's very disappointing, folks. I would love to hear some bands introducing the Metal Experience.
We'll do it.
You'll do it? Good. I'm holding you to it. I'm going to make you sign a contract after this.
Well,
so
that might
just
scare me.
Introduce yourselves. Play your music behind it. Say just Bill. Like how they do on B96, but make it so much better and so much funnier and entertaining. Hey, we're so-and-so, and you're listening to the Metal Experience. And say something else, and then boom, you're on the radio, and we get to play you every week in between commercials.
Dude, Dan,
that's awesome.
That's Dan's
so
work.
I don't want
to do
anymore.
Dan needs to do one.
You already said you were going to. Yeah, Dan for sure needs to do one.
Could you see Dan? Hi, my name is Dan Reitz. Fuck my ass. You're listening to the Metal Experience.
I don't care what it says. We need some stickers. I would love local
Dan
music.
It'll take five minutes. I could do your vocals right after we wrap up the interview thing.
That's
right. Like, hey, I'm Dan from One Steel Wound. Fuck my ass. This is the Metal Experience.
You got it.
We'll do it.
You got it. Oh, and we'll do that, too.
Nah, okay.
Nah, you're going to fuck my ass. That's right.
Oh, man. It got weird.
I would tear you apart.
We didn't go there.
It got really weird.
I'm a bit loose. You might not.
Oh, my God.
I don't know. I'm pretty talented in that.
He's been known to throw. It's like throwing a hot dog down a hallway, man.
Oh, my God.
You know cucumbers? I can fit 10.
His asshole has been known. As they call it the Stargate portal.
Dan, you know cucumbers? He's like 11.
The images that I've never wanted to
it's
have.
It's like throwing a hot dog
guys,
through
come
a
on.
Town.
Oh my God.
Dan's been
How
shitting pancakes for the past
about
2 years.
Dicks like this with all dudes. I don't like being the only chick in
it's
the room
so,
sometimes.
So nobody's told
You're
her
not
that Dan is openly masturbated
right
in front of us?
Yeah. I mean, Dan was basically jerking off outside right now.
With his dollar store
with
salsa.
With his dollar store salsa.
You know, these sausage fests are getting real old. I would love more women to join metal bands so I can hang out with a female once
Well, that's a damn shame.
Yeah. I think we've had like four other chicks
Dan
on this
Dan told me outside
year.
He's on the verge of making that jump, so.
I mean, as soon as you have tits, I might feel comfortable.
What? He has tits. But I mean, Dan achieved the highest form of masturbation.
Oh, my God. Well, next week we have Testimony on with us. They're going to be awesome. Can't wait for that. We are going to have some good times with them. They've got some awesome albums that we've heard. We've seen them live, so Luco's been waiting on Testimony Beyond for a while. And we just rescheduled One Steel Wound to come back on December 30th with some music. They'll be the last show of 2014.
The brand
new Think you got
music.
What it takes, boys? Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Better.
Yeah.
Just remember, you got to put your own semen on the wall.
Three
times in a year, you're the first band to pull it off.
You have to supply your own semen for the walls.
Fucking, dude, you guys definitely need to do this. When you guys play the first track off the record, you need to put on the Tenacious D intro. Where
you're going to have to tell them in like 3 months from now. They're not going to remember it
now. I'm not going to remember this shit.
I want you to remember this shit.
This is so potent. It will get everyone in the front row pregnant.
This was a good 3-year anniversary show for you,
Luco. This next one's going to make you bleed through your ear pussies.
3 years now?
It's been 3 years for Luco on the Metal Experience. Officially now.
So how does it feel?
His first show was with Grace the Damned.
I had shrimp tacos today, and they were delicious.
My 2 years coming up, isn't it, Morgan?
What?
My like 2 or 3 year thing coming? 2 years.
3 years is coming up in November.
Yeah, something like that.
So we will celebrate when we get there, and then we'll have to figure out when Bill's 1 year will be.
Morgan.
That would be me. I've been here for 3.5 years.
Holy shit.
You got to buy half.
Yeah.
So let me interview you.
Well, it's wrapping up for the end of the night. It's 10:10.
Time to go.
Give him a quick question. What do you got?
All right. How did you get started working here at the Metal
Experience?
A Craigslist
ad.
Working here.
No joke. That's it was a Craigslist ad.
Yeah.
I was looking for acting spots because I did acting before, and I saw a radio ad, and I was like, huh.
Porn doesn't count as acting.
So
what? What did you say?
Okay, one last question for the night.
That does require acting.
Found out?
This has sausage on it. I wanted pepperoni. All
right.
I'll give you a pepperoni.
All right, I got one last question for Luco. That's impossible. All right, dude. Here's your last question.
Wait, this is for me or for Morgan?
For you.
Oh, sorry. I wasn't paying attention. Right. I was talking about pepperoni.
Spit it out.
All right. What is your annual salary here after taxes?
What? Zero?
My annual salary working at the Metal Experience after taxes.
-15?
Is probably negative.
Actually, change that. Oprah
negative
Winfrey,
like $7.
Barbara Walters, your wife. You got to fuck one, marry one, kill one. Go.
What were the three?
Choose wisely.
Oprah Winfrey,
these answers, Luco.
Barbara Walters, and your wife. You got to fuck one,
marry
one,
choose
kill
these very
one.
Who's
wisely.
My wife?
Really?
Whoever you want it to be.
Adele, that fat bitch.
Well, fuck you, too.
And that was the Meadow Experience. Thank you. Tune in next Tuesday when Morgan slaps the shit out of Luco.
I'm sorry. That fat bitch has got a beautiful voice.
Next,
I have her sing to
me all
day.
Next week's show is our official 3-year anniversary. That one might not be happening anymore.
Good. I'm going to be listening to Adele.
The tension rises.
Everybody place your bets now. Place them now.
Come on, man. That big fat bitch has got a wonderful voice. I'd just be like, listen, don't ever talk to me. You just have to sing everything you want to say to me.
What's with all the bitch talk? Come on.
I just love her that much. Well, what song are we going to go out with listening to, Dave? What else we got on that list?
All right, the last one we have here is
Creed.
No, it's Weekend Nachos.
Weekend Nachos. Let's fucking do it. Thank you guys again for coming on.
I am feeling Creed right now.
Yeah, thank you for saving us on short notice.
Let's do a real quick Creed clip.
Wait, we need to really quickly promote the show they're playing again someday.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Cue the Creed.
Cue it.
Cue.
Dave, we're waiting.
Please.
He's doing
Please
it.
Please don't do that.
Skip through it a little bit. All right. What's the show this weekend, guys?
Mojo's.
Fuck Creed.
October 10th. Featuring
it's October 5th.
October 5th, bro.
Fuck. Featuring Gerard Ortiz on bass, Mike Boyer on drums, and Brandon screaming like a cat on vocals. And Dan on guitar. Sex Panther.
There is Sex Panther cologne. I'll have you smell Luco later.
But yes, October 5th, Sunday, be there.
Sunday.
$10.
$10.
$15 at
True
the door.
True Steel Wound.
If you're going to do it right, goddammit.
Dan with his package will deliver.
Sunday. One Steel Wound at Mojo's. Dan will bring his package and the Michael Masturbate.
You do our speakers like that? You're so
annoying. Oh, no.
Oh, yeah!
Buy your tickets in advance now and receive Brandon Castillo's official hand job.
Whoa. There's hand jobs and packages
There's
on the
official
line?
Hand jobs?
And they just got like
whoa,
17
that
refunds.
That was an unauthorized one. You know they have the unauthorized DVDs? So that was the unauthorized hand job. And there's the official hand job.
You gotta show us this secret
back alley.
Yeah,
it's like a secret handshake.
When we get outside, that's what our pictures are going to be. They're going to be the official blowjob picture and the unofficial blowjob picture, and you're going to show us how it's done.
Well, we
demonstrate on Bill over there. He loves it.
Besides being in the band, we also run a sex
trafficking. What can I say?
I bet that beard can catch a lot of.